of course, thank you very much for keeping it urban today, right here on Urban Television. It's that segment that is called Body and Mind. And it is here that we talk about anything to do with body and mind things. Yeah, and of course, today we had decided to have a lady in studio to talk about the things that interest the ladies. You know, things to do with pedicure, manicure, things that I don't even understand. I don't even know what these things mean, but because they didn't say I have to learn these things for today, I was like, okay, I have no option, but let me just flow the conversation. But of course, I have a specialist, I have a CEO of a beauty shop, I have someone who has been doing this business for quite some time, someone who actually left engineering after studying for 5 years, and she's into this whole beauty kind of thing. You know, I think she's going to help me understand this more than ever. How are you doing, Maxine?
I'm doing quite well, thank you.
Good to have you on the show.
Thank you for inviting me.
Please introduce yourself to the people one more time.
So I am Maxine Mancinenta. Mm-hmm. I'm founder and CEO of Livara, okay. Shea Butter Cosmetics. Mm. We manufacture hair, skin, body products, mm-hmm. here in Uganda, the Uganda Industrial Research Institute. Mm-hmm. And we retail them in Livara specific outlets.
Okay.
So in one of the outlets, we have a beauty salon, mm-hmm. where we use our products to work on ladies and gentlemen, okay. not just the ladies.
I mean, the outlet I've seen is all full of the ladies. I never see any gentlemen.
Of course, we have to have men to appease. Mm. Sorry, we have to have women to appease the men. Mm. Men prefer being worked on by women. Mm. But these days, you find men actually grooming themselves seriously.
Okay.
And the numbers are comparable to those of the women.
Mm. Interesting. Now, before we actually dive into this whole beauty thing, let's begin by talking about yourself. One thing that I've actually always wanted to ask you the moment I get a chance, what inspired you to leave the engineering bit of your life? You actually quit your engineering job after studying for all those years to take up this whole beauty parlor kind of thing.
Passion and self-satisfaction.
Okay.
Much as I was doing engineering, I had a very good job with Schlumberger, the world's biggest oil and gas service company. Mm. I was a practicing petroleum engineer in Congo. It was amazing. For engineering work, it's the epitome that you can really get. But in the end, you know, before you go back home, before you sleep at night, you ask yourself a few questions. Are you really happy doing whatever it is that you're doing?
Mm-hmm.
Are you adding value to the world the way you feel you are supposed to add value? Mm. Or is it just an empty job whereby you go appear at work, do what you have to do, do it well, and go back and sleep?
Mm-hmm.
So I had reached the point whereby I wasn't doing what it is that I really wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't happy. I would cry at night. I was just lost.
You would cry?
In that. Yes.
Like literally crying?
You know, you get depressed. You
may be crying.
Like, no. You get depressed, ooh. Real crying. You have money in the bank, but you're just not happy.
Okay.
And we even had cases of suicide and people just doing all sorts of things because you're not happy.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, I like making people look beautiful because for me it's instant. I mean, you put some makeup, you put some lipstick, it's instant. And someone smiles and they get happy instantly.
Mm.
And that goes a long way in personal growth and satisfaction. You know, when you look good on the outside, your productivity improves tremendously on the inside and in the things that you do. So for me, I believed I wanted to add value that way because from a young age, it's what I really like to do. I like tweezing people's eyebrows, cutting people's hair. I used to shave my brother's hair. I learned how to tweeze on my sister.
Mm.
At school, I used to, you know, do the little makeup on our social days.
Mm. So prom days.
Uh-huh. Mm. Prom. These days, that's what it's called. Mm. So for me, that's what I really wanted.
Okay.
But I wanted to do it big.
Right.
So I wanted to start my own company that makes my products to do what I want to do the way I want it done.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I had saved up some money, came back and started this. And then also I want to prove to the world that we can do it in Africa.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, have international standard products, but made in Africa.
quite interesting. You seem to have a very huge story that we could actually get into even as far as the whole day concerns. But now let's actually zero it down to the pedicure and manicure.
Mm-hmm.
Something that confuses the hell out of my head. First and foremost, what is manicure? What is pedicure? What's the difference?
Okay. I see you have pretty nails. So clearly you've done some manicure in a way.
Nah, fam. I haven't.
Anyway. Manicure and pedicure is all about treatment of the nails.
Okay.
There are different processes of doing it. For example, manicure, the word manicure originates from a Latin ensemble of words, mani and cura, which is nail,
mm-hmm.
hand rather, treatment. And then it came as in, there's a French word, manucure,
mm-hmm.
which was then transformed into manicure, which is just hand treatment.
Okay.
The same applies to the feet, but for the feet it's now pedicure.
Mm.
So what does it entail?
Mm.
It entails removing dirt from the nails,
mm-hmm.
clipping the nails and shaping them into a satisfactory shape. Some people like, you know, that,
mm-hmm.
others like this, others like that.
Mm-hmm.
So just shaping them, right? And then people can go a step further and do a scrub using either natural scrubs like sugar and olive oil,
mm-hmm.
or doing the processed scrubs with different stones to help remove the top dead skin.
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, some go ahead to do some steaming of the hands, and then apply some massage oils, and then top it off with coloring the nails.
All this is manicure.
It's a treatment of
treatment.
The nails. So depending on how much your pocket can afford, or how far you want to go in feeling nice, it's the stages that you want to do. Then also the treatments can be done at home or at the salon. Then we also go a step further if we want to make our nails look a little more artificial.
Mm-hmm.
So we can put the fiberglass or acrylic on top of them
what
to elongate them.
What they call artificial nails.
Yes.
Okay.
Or we can just put the plastic tips to make them look longer and color those. So you end up seeing, you know, like slay queens all over the place, long nails, and some jewels here and there.
I want to ask you a personal question, but I think it will come later on. Now, let's talk about the time difference where one does their pedicure to the next time they actually come back to the salon to the next pedicure. I have encountered a couple of female friends, and, you know, it's always about like a week and also a week, 2.5, you know, 2 weeks, 3 weeks. And then they're always telling you, no, I'm going back to the salon. I'm going to do pedicure. I'm going to do manicure. Then a week later, I'm still going back to the salon. I'm going to remove my nails. So how long would it take someone to actually go and redo her manicure or pedicure?
These days, there are different types of nail polish, right? There's what you call the gel, which lasts up to a month or two.
Okay.
Then there's the normal lacquer, the normal nail polish, which lasts 2 weeks maximum for before it chips. So depending on how fast your nails have grown or how chipped the nail polish is will mainly determine how often you go to the salon. Or it could be in someone's calendar. Every Saturday I go to the salon, I redo my nails because maybe the color has, you know, irritated me this week. I want to do another color. Or it's just a plan. I mean, the man pays for it and you go and do them, or you pay for them yourself and you go and do your nails. It depends on one's schedule and how one feels they need to change the color, especially on their nails.
Now, we all know the advantages of the beauty that comes with, you know, having your nails done and, you know, those artificial nails, like you said. Now, what are some of the disadvantages that come with this manicure or pedicure?
The disadvantages lie more with the acrylic fiberglass extensions to the nails because the nails have to be roughened up for the fiberglass to have something to clip onto. Now, as the nails are growing, the actual natural nail, because it was roughened up, tends to break in the process. So after, say, 1 month, when someone is taking off the artificial nail, they find that their actual nail is damaged and you have to just let it grow out. And it's usually ugly a bit because it's chipped. You let it grow out and drop off eventually. Okay. So that's the main disadvantage.
Mm-hmm.
But otherwise, beauty is about looking good. It has more pros than cons. I mean,
mm-hmm.
you may be having a tough day at work, or you know, something is going wrong in your life somehow.
Mm.
But at least your nails look good and they make you happy.
Is that why you don't make your nails and give them those cuticle and whatnot, that facial nails? Because they look very, 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 very artificial, very natural, just like mine here.
Luckily, I'm blessed with my natural nails
mm.
looking nice. So for me, and I do a lot of handwork. So it's more advantageous for me to have them void of nail polish because,
okay.
you know, we work a lot.
So what's the best advice you would give to someone, a lady out there who actually does a lot of manicure and pedicure, as we wrap up?
Look good. It doesn't hurt to look good.
Mm.
If it's your nails that make you feel good, go and manicure them every day if you really have to. It's all about color and removal of color. But as you're doing it,
mm-hmm.
make sure you have a base coat first, a primer, then the color, and then the seal to protect your actual nails, because you don't want your nails also dyed up and changing color because of the frequent change of colors. So nails, and it's grooming. Feel
so you
good,
provide
look
all
good.
The services at your...
At Livara?
Livara?
Of course we do. Yes, we do.
Where is the nearest from here?
We have one at Kampala Boulevard
mm-hmm.
and another one at Ntinda.
Okay, I've
and
seen
then,
that one.
Yeah, mm-hmm. we're stocking up with Guardian Health Pharmacy, which has 7 branches. So we shall have specialized Livara stores in every Guardian Health Pharmacy.
Mm.
We had one at the Cube, but closed it so that we can expand.
Okay.
With Guardian Health, which is in Chisementi
mm-hmm.
anyway, and other branches, yeah.
All right, thank you very much, Maxima, for your time. I really
thank
appreciate
you.
It. I think next time we'll have you on the show to broaden on this conversation or even get into how you started this in particular.
Yeah,
but for the
you.
Ladies out there, please go get some manicure and pedicure. And for you, Didan, on your birthday, manicure, pedicure on me. Done deal. So we'll see you guys right after this break.